We've got a jam-packed episode for you all. If you're new to the channel, we bought the Autozam AZ-1 back in September 2021 with the dream of building it into one of the coolest, fastest K-cars on the planet. For those unfamiliar with this K-car, it comes packed with a turbocharged, three-cylinder engine and a unique gullwing door design. Check that out. Yep, you heard that right. This little beast is all about performance and style. But buckle up, because we have wheels, suspension, and more installed and nearly ready to go. We took the AZ-1 to my boy Nathan at the gear shop here in Calgary, Alberta, to kick off our extensive list of mods. The gear shop, while they specialize in off-road and overland vehicles, they'll work on pretty much anything. They offer customers vehicle maintenance, repairs, alignments, detailing, shock rebuilding, fabrication, and full vehicle builds.
As you can tell, it's a beautiful day in Calgary, and we just got back to the shop. We're here at the gear shop. That's right, the AZ-1 is actually in the shop, and it's perfect timing because we can't drive it up in this weather. All right, we're here with Matthew, feeling all awkward, standing here like an anchor. He's anchoring down the team as we anchor the car into the garage.
What?
On a lift, so it's not really an anchor, but let's get in there. Let's see what's new with the AZ-1.
We're swapping out the stock wheels for 15-inch gunmetal Weds TC105X wheels. These bad boys are extremely lightweight and engineered for some serious track performance. We've also got some meaty tires in the form of Bridgestone Potenza RE71RS, and we have some spacers on the way to get it properly fitted to our fender flares. We might have to do a big brake kit as well, but at least we have discs all around. We're cutting the fenders so our new, beefier wheels and tires will fit without any rubbing. We're also modifying the side skirt for a vent at the front. Not only will this fix the rubbing issue, but will be functional at the same time. We're also going to be dropping the ride height with some JDM coilovers manufactured by Navic in Japan. These should help the car handle better and make it feel more solid all around corners. I should also mention that it's so hard to find parts for this car because it's so rare. I swear, you actually need someone who speaks fluent Japanese to find any type of parts. We've got strut bars installed as well for structural rigidity. If you remember from a previous video, after we got into a heated little race with a girl in a Mini Cooper, the car was wobbling all over the road as soon as we hit 80 kilometers per hour.
Oh, she's pulling up! Oh, all right. It's time! Holy this thing is wobbly. Holy this thing is dangerous. All right, no speeding.
All right, you 64 horsepower enthusiasts. We're slamming this fiberglass hood and ending off this video with a bold farewell to some rusty parts, chopped up fenders, and trailer tire wheels. Goodbye for good. We're going wider, not cutting corners, just fenders, and we're looking forward to dialing in these coilovers for the perfect stance. Stay tuned for our next episode, and if this video ain't enough and was just another tease, be sure to check out our app TCN, the Car Network, on the App Store for iOS. Get yourself some epic car wallpapers. Like, subscribe, blah, blah, blah. Peace.
Yes.
AZ-1. AZ-1.